What are you going to talk about today?
Hello, everyone. Thank you for having me here. So my topic is how to manage a remote team, and all of you have been associated with automatic in one way or the other. Needless to say, it is the $1 billion completely remote startup, and I was part of it some time back. Although I am from a marketing background, but then I switched to operations a couple of years ago, and I've been managing remote teams across time zones, and just wanted to share my experience with you and answer your questions.
Wow, and it's been how long that you've been managing a remote team?
I think it's been 5 years.
5 years now, wow. So that's great. We are really excited to see your experience and share it with others. Thank you.
Thank you, thank you. All right, so let me begin. Wonderful photo, right? So can anybody actually tell me what's wrong with the photo? Clothes. And? Sorry? No? No, no. ये तो मैंने सोचा भी नहीं था. And? So when we see on internet how remote works, ऐसी picture, somebody sitting on the beach, somebody in the pool with a laptop is something very common. I don't know how many of you have had such experiences, क्योंकि मुझे तो laptop गिराने का डर रहता, तो मैं तो कभी पानी में नहीं जाती. But ठीक है, ये भी ठीक है, whatever sells. So let me start with the basic difference between work from home, remote friendly, remote first, and a hybrid team. Now, remote from home is something what Reliance Jio essentially offers in India. It is something like out of 5 days, perhaps if your mother is sick or you are sick, you can work from home for a day. Now, remote friendly, generally the business team and the management team is co-located, while the development team is distributed across time zones. Generally, companies of such remote friendly culture would be, I think GitLab and GitHubs are some of the examples. Unki development team distributed hoti hai aur unki management team ek jagah hoti hai. Remote first, obviously something that we all love, completely dispersed, automatic buffer, so many of them are Zapier, Doist. Now something interesting is hybrid remote team. So I delved into this topic 3 years ago when I was setting up a hybrid remote team for a SaaS company in the US. And this was something very challenging, very unique. Isme kya hota hai? Irrespective of your roles, some of you are located in the office in a specific time zone, some are distributed in the same time zone, and the third section is distributed across time zones. So by far, in my experience, a hybrid remote team is the most difficult to manage, because we all know office drama to sab mein hota hi hai. Now, managing a remote team. So if you go on the internet, actually, it's quite funny that everybody has projected managing a remote team as something very rosy, something that requires a lot of skills, or something out of the world. Aisa kuch nahi hai. It is something like how you manage your in-house team. The only thing is that instead of relying on in-person, in-touch communication, you are relying on basic tools of communication. So there is absolutely no rocket science to it. Now, as you know that most of the remote teams are startups. Automatic was a startup. I think it is still a startup, I'm not sure. Anybody, is it still a startup? A $1 billion startup? Yeah, so Automatic is still a startup. Then the challenge here comes that they have low budget. Basically startup, you know how the funders are. They have restricted time, low budget, and usme unko unicorn banna hai. Matlab wo ek muhavra hai na, फटी हुई चद्दर में से पाव बाहर निकालना. तो मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टार्टअप्स आर फॉलोइंग दैट ट्रेंड. सो मिलेनियल्स एक्चुअली लव दिस ट्रेंड, एंड आफ्टर मिलेनियल्स द टर्म बूमर्स हैव कम, जो अभी रिसेंटली पाँच छः साल पहले बच्चे पैदा हुए. अभी आई वी डोंट नो दैट व्हाट ट्रेंड आर दे गोइंग टू ब्रिंग, बट मिलेनियल्स डेफिनेटली लव दिस. इट इज though I said it is easy, but a remote functioning in a remote team is one of the hardest things that I have actually done. There's so many challenges which we'll address to here. Sabse pehle to time zone, cultural and language barriers aata hai. The interesting thing is, agar tumne unko bata diya tum India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka se ho, to tumhare ko Appu from the Simpsons bana ke hi chhodenge. They just cannot get it that you have a clear accent in English. Second thing, they'll automatically understand that you have a programming background. Uske alawa India mein developer ke alawa koi paida nahi hota hai. Hey, how many developers here, by the way? I know Chetan is there. Chetan, raise your hand. So you see, developers ke alawa bhi India mein log hote hai. Now, understanding this challenge, so what happens is when you are an operations manager at a big startup, you have air in the head. And that is true because tum LinkedIn hero ho, tum WordCamp hero ho, tum idhar hero ho, tum udhar hero ho, people are flocking towards you. So you basically get an attitude, and that is quite obvious and natural. But the thing is that you have to keep in mind, agar tumhare itna attitude hai, then you will not be able to run the company successfully. So that is something that people have to understand. Keeping the team interested, motivated and glued. Sorry developers, but the hardest thing to do is keeping the developers interested. I think programming is such a vast area jahan pe aap you spend a lot of time coding, and kyunki aap itne dedicate ho jate ho that you may or may not socially interact that much, that actually becomes a problem, which I'm not saying is bad, but it's a different kind of problems that people have to address to. And plus developers itne demand mein hote, you are always on the back foot thinking that somebody else is not going to steal your developer. It's very hard. Like, I know Puneet has been looking for plugin developers, and you know he's had a hard time looking for it, so I can pretty much understand that how valuable developers are. Risk mitigation and detection. You never know kya ho jahe remote team mein. You never know. Basically, you are on the tip of your toe 24 hours. There's somebody working in Hawaii who's up at 2 when you are sleeping, who's somebody working in Australia who has some issues when it's morning in your time. So you have to be really responsive outside your work hours to make it work. Salary barrier. I think, I hope most of you had at one point faced it, because that's the biggest disparity in a remote team if you are located in countries like Asia, Thailand, India, Bangladesh, Africa. Automatically wo aapki salary one-third kar dete / wahin aap Western Europe ya Northern America mein ho, to they'll offer you 100K and above. That is something that we will definitely come back to. Trust issues. I've seen that a lot with Indian companies. Pata nahi unko apne employees pe trust kyun nahi hota, I have never understood. And of course, many more, which we will come back to. The biggest thing, distractions. Kis ko hota hai, kaun beech mein YouTube dekhta rehta hai? Aise sharmao mat, main nahi hire kar rahi, sab dekhte honge. So this is the biggest distraction even for me. I have been guilty of passing stupid memes on Slack channel. Ek do bar to mujhe bola bhi hai ki tumhare ko Slack channel se hata denge, bakwas band karo. So this is something we all do. So as I was telling you, that managing a remote team is no rocket science. The most important thing is to be human. Now, when I say being human, I don't mean be something like Salman Khan, ki logo ko pedestrians ko maar ke ja rahe hain, but be human. Care about your people. That is most important. Give them benefit of doubt. If somebody you know is not doing well, if you know usko bahane maarne ki aadat hai, and yet that person has come up with an excuse to take a day off, give them the benefit of doubt. Of course, if it happens, if it keeps happening over a period of time, there's recurrence, you see a pattern, yes, you should raise a flag. But I think when you are not connected physically, or you don't know the person in person, the best thing is to believe what the person has to say. So now we'll start with something jo aapne bahut baar internet pe padha hai, but I'm going to bring all these things in with a different twist from my own experience. Encourage transparency. So when we say transparency, hum sab ne सारा लिटरेचर पढ़ा है कि हायरार्की लेवल्स ओपन होने चाहिए, सीईओ से बॉटम बिजनेस डेवलपमेंट मैनेजमेंट तक एवरीबडी शुड बी रेडी टू लिसन, एक्सेसिबल एंड एवरीथिंग. बट दैट्स नॉट व्हाट आई वांट टू टेल यू अबाउट ट्रांसपेरेंसी हियर. ट्रांसपेरेंसी ऑल्सो हैपन्स व्हेन यू आर अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर. नाउ व्हाट हैपन्स इन रिमोट टीम्स इज जनरली इफ दे आर नॉट अ बिग कंपनी दे विल हायर यू एज अ कॉन्ट्रैक्टर. They'll hire you on per hour basis. So basically, you are not an employee but a contractor. So whenever financial transactions happen, it generally happens within the sales and marketing departments. Unko problem hota hai. Sale hua, you've been told another figure. The actual figure is different. Because you are earning a commission, they'll tell you a different figure and you might end up earning less on your commission. So this is a very malafide practice. It is basically a recipe for disaster, because you may carry it on for a year or two, but sooner or later things will open up and you will lose your valuable employees. So when I say transparency, it is absolute transparency. One such example is Amazon. Amazon ka ek apna khud ka internal channel hai, something like Slack, where you can actually approach Jeff Bezos also with your issues. Koi jo naya kal ka trainee aaya hai, wo bhi CEO se baat kar sakta hai. So, agar transparent culture dekhe, to mujhe Amazon, I think it's the perfect example. But of course, Amazon has its own challenges, which we will not bother with. But this is how a transparent company is built. So basically, be accessible. Let your employees know they are valued. Let them know what they've done. Appreciate them. It is very, very important. Aapko sales aa raha hai aur aap apna ek vacation house khareed rahe ho. That is good. But at least jo aapko vacation house dila raha hai, you should appreciate that person. Yeah, I've been actually guilty of doing this. Abhi aur kaun kaun kiska office desk kaisa hota hai? Bas. Oh, come on, there has to be more people. Don't lie. How many of you work from the bed? Forget office decks. Kaun bistar mein se hi kaam kar leta razai mein se nikal ke? So this is something that I actually never thought this would slow my process down. But some time ago, I attended a remote global summit and udhar kisi ne ek bahut acha bataya. And that is actually when I realized that, yes, this clutter and, you know, phela hua saman was actually slowing me down, because half the time I was just running through my papers to find something. Now, when I say organize work and lay down processes, it also means that how your company will function. I know so many remote companies, they have actually picked up literature from Zapier or Buffer, because they have the most elaborate, extensive processes laid down on their website. But Zapier ke liye kaam karta hai, aur Doist ka article Doist ke liye kaam karta hai, wo hamare liye kaam nahi karta. So as a remote manager, you have to keep doing trial and error till you hit the head. What works for you, what works for your team, and whatever works for your team, you have to document it. It is utmost necessary, because what has happened was, it has happened with me in the past, when you don't document it, when you just rely on Slack channels or emails and you say ki acha kahin to likha hai usko baad mein dhoond lenge, you know, when time comes that kahin to likha hai and dhoond lenge never happens, and then you might get into a legal battle, which actually in remote teams gets nasty, because your company is headquartered somewhere, let's say in one of those fancy rich countries like England and US, and you are sitting in India. अगर आप अंबानी के बच्चे हो तो आप उधर लॉयर अफोर्ड कर लो, लेकिन मेरे और आपके जैसे जनरली वी कांट अफोर्ड अ लॉयर. सो यू गेट इनटू अ नास्टी थिंग, एंड देन इट्स सच अ स्मॉल वर्ल्ड द रिमोट वर्किंग, दैट योर नास्टीनेस एक्चुअली कम्स आउट, एंड द अदर पीपल हु आर लुकिंग टू हायर मे नॉट हायर यू, बिकॉज दे नो ऑफ योर क्रेडिबिलिटी. यू एक्चुअली लूज योर क्रेडिबिलिटी. सो द थिंग इज दैट, यू नो, इट इज एब्सोल्युटली पिवोटल टू ऑर्गेनाइज योर प्रोसेस एंड ले डाउन व्हाट समथिंग एज सिंपल एज हाउ टू टेक अ लीव. You have, so you, as a new person who comes into the workplace, the person should know, okay, my leave would be approved by this person or this person. If I have to, if I have to ask somebody, then this is my mentor. So of course, assigning a mentor like many remote companies do is absolutely important for this process also, because they know everything. Yeah, meetings. How many of you spend more than 2 hours a week in meetings if you're working remotely? 2 hours? Who else? Nobody else? Aap se koi remote worker hai yahan pe? So how many hours do you spend? Achha, okay, aap wo agile aur kanban wale hain. Haan, ek ye bhi hai, agile aur kanban system bhi hai. So when I talk about regular meetings, there are like two types of meetings, synchronous and asynchronous. Synchronous meeting is essentially, I think you can understand from the name, is aap sab Zoom pe saath mein ya Google Meet pe baith ke face to face baatein kar rahe ho, discussions ho rahe duniya bhar ke, and you basically wasting time. Asynchronous was something that was started by Doist, and it is something like after the time, so Slack messages, emails, to Doist ka apna jo Slack ka version hai, Twist, unka communication tool, us pe meetings. So asynchronous meetings actually save you a lot of time. You don't have to sit through, agar aap marketing wale ho, aapko finance ko kyu daat padi hai, you don't have to listen to that. So you will directly get what you are supposed to do, what's the problem with you, or whatever your superior has to communicate to you. I don't know how funny is that, but I've actually sat in meetings jahan pe C executive class was talking on I don't know what all things to somebody, and I was just whiling away my time for 4 hours. And that's when one of the operational person suggested that we switch to asynchronous meetings. And it was quite sad that for 4 hours ke liye I was being paid and kuch nahi karna hota tha, but then I lost my money, but then I had more productive time. So regular, when I say regular meetings, you hold regular meetings. It shouldn't last more than 2 hours a week, definitely. And be concise. Abhi meeting mein baith ke ek aa raha hai, ji ek coffee banane chala gaya, ek apne kutte ko ghuma raha hai. Ye sab, it's just waste of time. Now, ye to sabko, sabne suna hi hoga aur sab use karte hi honge. And how many of you use Slack regularly? See, so many of us. How many of us use Basecamp, Trello, Jira boards, Evo, Confluence, Fadlana Dimka? Trello, huh? So when we say time tracking tools, people think of Toggle or something, jahan pe aap time track kar rahe ho, jahan pe aap, you can actually show it to your superior what you're doing and all. So last year, I was working on a project with Doist, and they did not use any time tracking tool. They did not use any communication tool apart from emails. So it was sort of an experiment that the team did, and they realized that everybody was saving 8 hours a month, which they could have used it for something else, something more productive towards the company. So when I say time tracking tools, if you are an independent contractor, aapko bill karne ke liye apna time dikhana hai, that is good enough. But then if you are an employee of a remote company, I think this entire thing should be done away with, because your manager should have enough faith in you. It doesn't matter aap raat ke 2 baje kaam kar rahe ho, if you're working at 6 in the morning, as long as you're meeting the deadlines, as long as your KPI, your metrics, your goals are met, it really doesn't matter. I think there was this quote on the internet which said that I spent 30 years learning what I could do in a half an hour. So pay me for those 30 years that I spent to learn what I did in half an hour, not for the half an hour. So you should be valuing yourself on your skills, not on how many hours you've put in. Ab 10 minute mein kar lo kaam, very good. But that manager should pay you for those skills and not for the time that you have taken to complete that task. Yeah. Yeh toh. Every, wahan bhi pehle na aapka registration bhi nahi hua hai remote team ka, remote company ka, pehle aap company culture kahin process street se copy karke le aate. You know, this is something that most of the companies are guilty. So company culture, itna I've heard company culture, and I used to think, pata nahi kya culture bana rahe. It is actually nothing. What your company culture is, what you do at home, how do you interact with people, who is in the hierarchy, what are the processes, what are your benefits, perks, like what people are expected to. It's as simple as that. And when I say that you build a company culture, sabko lagta hai sabse pehle to Slack pe teen channel bante hain. I'll tell you, new joinees. क्योंकि सबको उनकी लेनी होती है तो सब न्यू ज्वाइनीज ज्वाइन करते हैं ठीक है फिर एक वाटर कूलर तो बनना चाहिए भाई उसके बिना तो किसी का स्लैक कंप्लीट नहीं होता है एंड एक बनता है कि चलो वो आपके अपने इंडिविजुअल काम के हिसाब से चैनल्स है नाउ दिस वाटर कूलर चैट इट इज सच अ यूजलेस थिंग With one of the companies I was working, of course, a huge, huge remote company, what had happened was water cooler chat actually became a way to pull legs of other employees, which over time turned into nastiness. And then, of course, the HR had to pitch in, ki bhaiya bahut ho gaya. This is borderline racism. So if your water cooler chat is turning into somebody's moment of unhappiness, what's the point of having such company culture? Just do away with this water culture thing. It doesn't matter, a water cooler thing. Koi baat nahi. Instead, encourage people in within the same channels or within the same department to interact more. Abhi, what happens is you are being paid for the time you spend on doing a task. You're not being paid for off-the-task conversations with your colleagues, which is very important. Because if you don't talk to your colleagues, if you don't ask random questions, or if we do it in the office, what was Diwali, what was Navratri, if you don't ask, how are you going to communicate with essential things? Then you'll have that ice. And the biggest problem in remote team is communication. If you're not clear, if you do not have that rapport with the other person, wo kya bolta, tum kya sunte, teesra insaan kya karta, fir to khichdi pak jani hai. So the thing is, do away with all this nonsense, water cooler chat and all, but focus on the thing that you have to encourage your employees to interact with their colleagues. Yeah, I just wanted to take a break. By the way, ye sabse valuable, sabse mehengi slide hai kyunki pyaas bahut mehenga hai. So when we come to this, set clear goals and expectations. This is actually very important. Like I told you, in a remote team, miscommunication is one of the major challenge. And usme, if your goals and expectations are not communicated clearly enough, then you have problems. Like in a normal office, we've heard, "Arey, humne to socha tha, usko ye karna tha." Nahi nahi, maine to socha, usko ye karna tha. In remote team, if you keep doing this with team members spread across time zones, koi Hawaii mein hai, koi Australia mein hai, tum to din ke din hi, humne to ye socha tha, usne karna tha, phir tum pure ke pure din gayab kar doge. So the thing is that when whosoever joins your company first, that person should be told ki ye aapke goals hai, ye hum aapse expect karte hai, ye objectives hai, coupled with processes that this is how you reach your goal, that is very important. So this has to be very, very clear cut defined. And no misses on this. Ye nahi ki acha wo mere wo CEO ka koi rishtedar remote company mein laga hai to uske liye hum relax kar dete. No, there are no ifs and buts, and this is something we don't see happen generally in international teams, but haan, with Indian teams that I worked with, this has happened ki koi rishtedar kisi ka aa gaya hai, to uske liye sab maaf ho jata hai. This is not how you work in a remote team. So, as you see, Jetsons was the first person, itne saal pehle humare bachpan mein usne bata diya tha, ki this is how we'll communicate. But this point of video-based conference is something that very often you have all experienced, and perhaps you will be doing over-communication. That is something very important. Now, let me, what is over-communication? Has anyone ever over-communicated a thing? Nahin? So over-communication is sometimes, if, okay, let's say I sent an email to one of my colleagues, okay, A and B task have to be done. That colleague must be receiving hundreds of emails a week from other departments, and of course jo uske bahar ke client se emails aayenge, that's a separate issue. So there are chances that the person would forget, There are chances that that person might have problems. There are chances that that person has not even read your email, might have questions, and jab tak wo tumhare paas aayega, that thing is already over. So over communicate means emphasizing or keep letting that person know that this has to be done, or asking them if you have any issues or not. There's a very thin line between irritating that person and over communicating. So you need to know your boundary that you will not irritate that person. Ye nahi ki har aadhe ghante mein ek message piche se aa raha hai, bechara kuch bhi kar raha hai, usko piche se ek ping aa raha hai. No. But the thing is that, you know, give them 2 days. I mean, that's the general strategy or the general accepted norm. Give them 2 days. Nahi. Gentle reminder. Nahi. By the end of Friday, you should ensure that you have a reply from that person. Ab wo reply tum kaise bhi jao. For all I care, you go to that person's house, ring the bell and ask them. But the thing is that 5 days, a week time is a good enough time to receive a response. And that works both ways. Aise nahi ki jisko kaam hai wo hi ping karta rahega and samne wala ne apna ping mute kara aur masti se so raha hai. Nahi. It has to be both ways, and for that to happen, it is the operations manager role to keep the team so glued, so at par with each other, so comfortable with each other that people respond. Abhi jab humare ko kabhi se kisi se jhagda ho jata hai, khundas aa jata hai, what do? Jisko mazaa chikhate hai manager ke samne, ruk jao. So this attitude shouldn't happen. Kyunki maza to chakha diya manager ke samne, but ultimately jab CEO se maza aapko aayega tab aapki naukri jayegi. So do away with all these silly things. I mean, you know, it was nice when you were in school, but it doesn't happen this way in, when we are adult. Yeah, so trust and inclusivity. Now, inclusivity is such a funny term. I have actually spent so many hours reading about it, but still I am yet to find a remote team which actually doesn't have these two issues. Discrimination of some sort is always there. Trust issues obviously will always be there. Jahan pe paise ki baat aayegi, ghar ghar mein jhagda ho jata hai, to ye to remote team hai. So how do you do this? I am actually asking you all, if you actually work on remote teams, how do you guys ensure that the trust and inclusivity is always maintained? Anybody here who works, you work in a remote team, kya karte ho tum log? No, how do you maintain trust and inclusivity? No, how does your superior trust you? How do you have trust that something you are actually doing?
I do my work well, so he trusts me.
Yeah, so that's one point. Who else? Anybody? Yeah. Huh. But then, usme trust ka se aega? It's something like, you know, if, okay, I am being paid 4 hours a day for doing something, let's say sales. Main sales to kuch nahi lai, because sales, let's say I give this wonderful quote at the end of the day when I don't make a sale, saying that sales is all numbers. Aaj li number laga. So how do you ensure that you're working? How do you ensure trust? I think that could be one thing. I mean, I've always had issues with maintaining trust in remote teams. When you're working in remote teams, first of all, jab aapka hiring process hai, you've not met that person. Until unless ek hota hai na, jab hum insaan ke saath rehne lagte, to we come to know that if that person is trustworthy or not. But when you're working remotely, how do you ensure that your entire, yeah. So exactly, I think if you communicate with the person enough visually, you do tend to get a feeling that if the person's trustworthy or not. But sometimes what has happened, I've seen across time zones, is there are people who are not very social, in the sense they are introvert. They won't speak much during your conferences. So you automatically unko as a shady character assume kar lete, which is wrong. And this a lot of managers have been guilty of. Especially, essentially starts with the hiring process only. Jab aap applicants ka padhte ho resume, सबसे पहले तो मुझे लगता है कि दिस डिस्क्रिमिनेशन ओवर ज्योग्राफिकल एरियाज कम्स इनटू प्ले द मोमेंट आई कम टू सी ओ अच्छा ये तो मेरा हिंदुस्तानी भाई है पक्का ये तो कुछ ना कुछ गड़बड़ी करेगा यू नो सो एंड इट इज नॉट आई देर आर पीपल इन इन सम ऑफ द बिगेस्ट रिमोट टीम्स हु आर गिल्टी ऑफ दिस सो इट एसेंशियली स्टार्ट्स विद योर हायरिंग प्रोसेस फिर आप इंटरव्यू में जाते हो रिसेंटली आई वॉज There was this global nomad summit in Grand Canaria and I was watching one of the videos from that seminar and there was somebody who was complaining about Zapier. So that person went through all the rounds, everything and the last CEO round weighed the CEO of Zapier in 3 minutes rejected that person. And the person was shocked. Usse kuch nahin poocha. Bas he poocha, where are you from? Usne bataya, I'm from so-and-so country. Okay, that's a wrap. So that point actually brought out that how big this scene of discrimination is even in a company like Zapier jo apne aap ko aaj ki tarikh mein sabse achhi remote company jiske hum processes hum sabne copy kare hain all of us have been guilty so this is how important trust and inclusivity is so as an operations manager what I would suggest is when you start hiring you start with an open mind matlab apne dimag mein kuch mat dalo ki ye south asia ka hai ye africa ka hai another country to be discriminated is all these oceania countries fiji kiribati agar wahan se kabhi koi aa jaye tonga We discriminate a lot. Even as an Indian, I have discriminated against certain Africans. So the thing is that you don't discriminate. You just start with an open mind. You just start. अभी कितने सारे लोग जब हम YouTube पे कोई Nigerian को comment करते हुए देखते भी also ये तो पक्का Nigerian prince है जो हमें $1 billion जितवाएगा lottery में. You know, we just think of Nigerians and scammers. That's not true. And kahin na kahin wo joke is something based on reality. So when you start with trust, it starts with the hiring process. And when you talk about inclusivity, please think that, how many of you are mothers here? This is from my personal experience. Anybody? Okay, I am a new mother. So I took a sabbatical from my job because when I was pregnant and my daughter was very young. So what had happened when I joined back? I was actually discriminated against. A lot of the people said, oh, your daughter is so young, tum toh kaam nahin kar paogi, so we can't hire you. And that is a very wrong notion, very wrong. हम सबकी mothers हैं जो काम करती हैं, हम सब कितने की working moms हैं, but क्या उन्होंने हम सबको upbring अच्छे से नहीं करा? So as whosoever, if you are a recruiter, if ever you hire somebody, please don't start with a certain tag or a stigma कि इसको तो कुछ आएगा ही नहीं, ये नई mother है, ये कुछ नहीं कर सकती, ये इस country से, ये नहीं, ये Indian, Bangladesh, पाकिस्तानी श्रीलंकन है इसने टप्पू के जैसे बोलना ही है या मैट फ्रॉम कॉल सेंटर वन हो जाएगा ऐसे नहीं होता सो दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इफ यू हैव ट्रस्ट एंड इफ यू आर डिस्क्रिमिनेशन फ्री एट योर वर्क प्लेस यू विल बी द नेक्स्ट यूनिकॉर्न वो अलग बात है फिर बाद में पेटीएम या रैनबैक्सी जैसी हरकतें कर दो तो जेल जाओगे पर यू स्टार्ट बेसिकली गुड सो ग्रैंड से या This is something that I have been guilty of. I have hired people and then I have conveniently forgotten कि उनको उनकी कंपनी का वो दे दो एड्रेस दे दो I have conveniently forgotten कि उनको अपने बेस कैम्प ट्रेलो पे ऐड करो एंड बहुत मैंने ऐसी गलतियाँ करी हैं एंड बहुत गाली भी खाई है उसके लिए सो बेसिकली वेन यू हायर समबडी द मोमेंट यू हायर दैट वेरी फर्स्ट डे लेट दैट पर्सन गेट यूज टू योर कंपनी लेट दैट पर्सन गेट यूज टू द कलीग्स उनको सारे आप एक्सेस दो उनको सपोर्ट दो उनको सब कुछ आप प्रोवाइड करो टूल्स अच्छा वील जस्ट रैप अप हाँ जल्दी जल्दी गोल सेंट्रिक नॉट एक्टिविटी सेंट्रिक इज समथिंग व्हाट आई रिट्रेटेड कि आप गोल्स को देखो इंसान ने डेडलाइन उसने जो ऑब्जेक्टिव्स अचीव करे हैं उसको देखो इस पे मत देखो कि कितने घंटे लिए उसने अचीव करने के लिए हाँ सो एस्टैब्लिश बॉन्ड कनेक्शन एंड जेन्युइटी सो दिस इज समथिंग स्टैंडर्ड है ये जो फोटो है हम सबको आता है अभी इमेजिन इफ एन ऑपरेशंस मैनेजर इज सेंडिंग दिस ईमेल टू 3 अदर पीपल इन द कंपनी जिनका बर्थडे है कितना जेन्युइन हुआ तो ऐसी गलती मत करना प्लीज पर्सनलाइज एवरीबडी हैज एन इंडिविजुअल ट्रीट तो उसको आप चेरिश करो उसको आप एनकरेज करो ये टीम रिट्रीट्स अभी ये तो भाई मैंडेटरी हो जाता है रिमोट टीम में, अगर हमें बाली थाईलैंड नहीं लेके गए तो हम तो नहीं ज्वाइन करते टीम. पर ऐसा नहीं है, नॉट एवरीबडी हैज़ द बजट टाइम एंड स्पेस फॉर टीम रिट्रीट्स. यू कैन एक्चुअली हैव अ गुड रिमोट टीम विदाउट इवन हैविंग द टीम रिट्रीट्स. दिस इज इंडिया स्पेसिफिक चैलेंजेस, एवरीथिंग इज रिटन ऑन द बोर्ड सिंस वी हैव अ क्रंच ऑफ टाइम, बट आई विल जस्ट highlight on the socio-cultural aspects. This is something prevalent for South Asian countries. In fact, even South Asian, Southeast Asian countries. हम लोगों को इसमें घर में से लड़कियों को बाहर नहीं जाने देते, उधर ही उनका करियर चौपट हो जाता है, आप भले ही बी टेक, एम टेक, एम फार्मा कुछ भी हो. सो फॉर देम रिमोट वर्किंग और वर्क फ्रॉम होम इज अ ब्रिलियंट ऑप्शन. And there's no shame. There are families who don't encourage their daughters and their, you know, females to go out. So this is something that remote managers in India have to face. More employment, जैसे मोदी जी ने कहा कि हम इतने लोगों को employment देंगे, पता नहीं कितनों को मिला, लेकिन हम remote work के द्वारा ज़रूर दे सकते हैं. I actually came to know of somebody, I don't know that person, but wo Jhadol se he works from home, and if you are from Udaipur, you know Jhadol is a very very rural area outside the city. So yeah, basically, thank you. Any questions? I honestly don't think maine itna acche se kara, ya to aapne suna nahi ya kya problem ho gaya. May I let me know, and I'll be more than happy to clarify it for you. Thank you so much, and all the best.